Today, the third edition of the Kampala Innovation Week commenced in Kampala. Though held virtually, the Innovation Week will showcase entrepreneurs and startups already showing resilience and innovation when tackling the COVID-19 pandemic.
If I don't have access to funding to buy the machinery, to train the people that I train, good enough, you know, the UK aid, the UK government has believed in WASI Vision and has given us the funding that we needed to acquire the training, acquire the equipment. But what am I saying? I'm saying is if I'm going to transform this nation or create jobs in this nation, there has to be access to funding, access to resources that are going to build and train.
Uganda has put emphasis on the private sector. It has put so many regulations that it is giving with one hand and taking away with the other.
Opening the event today, the keynote speakers called for favorable working conditions for young innovators. Professor Balunywa also called upon the government to consider financing science education at all levels as a motivation for Ugandans to adapt to digitalization.
If Uganda is going to adapt to the digital changes, government must fund science education throughout, from primary, if you call it that, whatever requires science must put the money. Secondary, the labs must put the thing that you need, the reagents, in universities. Nobody should pay in the university to study science.
Over 300 innovators are said to participate in the event themed Digital Transformation and Job Creation in the Post-COVID-19 Economy. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.